the battle.
Battle?
Yes. Between Mercury and Ice.
Huh.
How much was it?
103.
Typhoid. Typhoid? Now I'm sure it's typhoid. Don't you worry. We now know what stick to employ to beat it with. Chloromycetin. Give her the prescribed dosage and she'll be fit as a fiddle. No more half-boiled meals for you. I'll see you a week later. Don't forget to take the temperature.
But doctor, my prescription.
Ah. Here.
Sushila. There. That's a good girl. You know what the doctor said? That with this miracle drug, you will be well within 2 or 3 days.
I think the fever is rising.
For the last 7 days, the fever hasn't come down.
The municipality has served me with a notice asking me to put a stone slab over my stormwater drain. But my lawyer said...
Last night she didn't take food.
Good for the country with all these food shortages. Do you know what the grain merchant from the market did? When he came to see me about his throat, he asked me if I was an M.D. I wonder where he learned about M.D.s. And what business does he have to ask me about the... Hey, are you all right? What's the matter, Krishna?
She was very restless last night. She kept tugging at her bedclothes all the time.
Perhaps she wants a different colored bedsheet. Why not?
I read somewhere that tugging of the bedclothes is a bad sign.
Oh, you and your reading. Why don't you try Lady Chatterley's lover?
Krishna!
Yes, what is it?
What does she want?
She wants to know when she will get up.
Oh, she'll be up before the next Olympics. I'd love to go to the Olympics myself.
Her temperature was 103 last night.
Did you keep the ice going?
Until my hands were numb.
Ah, we'll treat you for cramps by and by. But first, let's get the lady of the house back to the kitchen. I'll see you in a week.
The doctor asked you to stay in bed. Come on, get back.
Please have your lunch, sir. I'll sit with her for a while.
It's all right.
propriety. No respect for our glorious tradition and culture. This is a typical instance of the evils of modern education. Can't you wait for your elders to arrange your marriage?
But father...
Shut up! All you do is to ape Western manners and be great cinema stars.
So what's wrong with that? Everything else is perfectly acceptable, isn't it? Caste, group, sect, everything. If you wanted to be so orthodox and rigid, why did you waste all your hard-earned money on my school and college? You could have got me married off as a child.
All right, Krishna. Don't be angry.
Yes. Let's first match the horoscopes and then decide. What are you doing there? Get in.
Go inside.
No, they do not match. The boy's horoscope indicates Mars in the seventh house, and that is very dangerous. It could spell total disaster for the girl. As an astrologer, I would never recommend such a proposal.
That settles it then. There is no point in considering this proposal any further. How can you, a seeker for your daughter, be so finicky and insecure? Our son will get a bride 100 times superior to your daughter. After all, what has she to boast of? All college girls make themselves up to look pretty, but that is not everything.
That may be your view, sir, but after listening to the honored astrologer, I am not prepared to give my daughter to a slaughterhouse. I hope I am making myself very clear, sir.
Sushila, she has not come out of her room since last afternoon. She even refuses to take food.
I don't think you should be so rigid. Youngsters do act strange these days. Why don't you reopen negotiations with the boy's parents?
After all, the girl's happiness is our main concern, isn't it?
I know this famous priest on Mempi Hills who can be referred to for a flower sign. Why don't we all agree to a flower test?
Flower test?
There. The flowers are duly placed. If the red flower falls down, it's a bad omen. However, if the white flower falls down, you can get married immediately. Have faith in God, my son, and wait for the flower to fall.
How much longer, Pujariji? It's been 2 hours already.
People have waited for 2 days and more, sir.
Listen, I can't wait forever. I have to reach my Malgudi tuition classes by evening.
Be patient, sir. Be patient. Please explain to... Sir, we all know that a child is an incarnation of God. Isn't it, Pujariji?
Yes, yes.
Sunny, come here.
Hi.
Please come here.
Hi.
Come and pick your flower.
No.
Would you like a piece of coconut, son?
No.
Krishna, bring the child here. Come. Here.
Come on.
No.
Come on. Don't cry. Have this. The flower. Hey, pick it up.
Pick your flower.
Don't cry. You're a good boy, right? All you have to do is pick a flower. Right? Stop crying, son. Stop crying. What do we do now, Pujariji? This is inauspicious. The child has shown us the way.
Oh, how's our patient today? Fit as a fiddle?
No, doctor. The temperature's on a steady rise, despite the chloromycin.
Well, if it's not typhoid, it must be something else. But don't worry. We'll start other tests soon. I wonder what it is. Do you have any enemies?
No, except for some stupid forecast that Mars was in the seventh house.
Mars?
Yes, and this was supposed to spell disaster.
Oh, I knew it. Mars and some vague microbe have joined hands. Well, you take care of Mars, and I'll probe into the microbe.
Microbe?
Why didn't you pray for a change?
Pray?
Yes, why don't you say to God something like, Oh God, if you are there, save me if you can.
Do you recognize me, sir?
I knew you would come. I told you at the start itself how it would turn out. But you people would not listen to my words. Sit. Yes, Mars has begun to exercise its most malignant aspect now. Under these circumstances, survival of the person concerned is very doubtful.
What shall I do, sir? What would you advise me to do? Please help me. I know that the ruling god in Mars is benign. I wish I knew of a way to propitiate him and gain his compassion. Please help me, sir.
This is one of the four originals of the Brahat Jatakas. The entire science of astrology is based on this. This is what has given me my living. And when I speak, I only speak with the authority of these leaves. There can be no such thing as evading your fate. You can only insulate yourself against its rigors to a certain extent. When Angaraka is malevolent, appease it with prayers, rice, gram, and a piece of red silk. Pour the oblation of pure butter into a sandal stick fire for 4 days continuously, and feed 4 Brahmins. Can you do it? Why do you laugh? Do you think you're very modern? Can't you take these simple steps to achieve profound ends?
My wife is very ill. To make all these arrangements without her help.
Go away. I don't think I can help you. No, not now. Let your wife get well first. Then you give me money. The trouble is, your love is killing your wife. Yes. If you were an indifferent husband, she would have survived. The malignancy in Mars would have made her suffer, now and then. Mentally, not physically. But that would not kill her. I have seen horoscopes which were exact replicas of yours. But the wife lived to a ripe age. Do you know why? The husband was disloyal and cruel to her. And this, to some extent, neutralized the rigors of Mars in the seventh house. My son, I see your wife's time is getting to be really bad. Before anything happens to her, save her. If you can bring yourself to be disloyal to her, try that. Every man with a concubine has a wife who lives long.
Just a minute. Could you please stay at home this evening? I have to go out.
Now? Where?
Rangi, out.
I have to go home and feed my children.
It's very important. Please, just for this one evening.
All right. But I'll stay only till 9 o'clock.
That's perfectly all right.
You're going to get better soon. But it will cost something. Doesn't matter. Anything to save your life.
Where does Rangi live?
Which Rangi?
That famous temple dancer.
I don't know. Want a beetle leaf?
No. Excuse me, are you free?
Of course. Where do you want to go? I will take you anywhere.
Can you tell me where the temple dancer Rangi lives?
Why do you want her?
I just wanted to see her dance.
At this hour? With so much silk and so much perfume on? Don't try to deceive me, sir.
When you come out of her house, she will have stripped you of all your silk and perfume.
But tell me first, why only Rangi? There are others. Both experts and beginners. I have carried hundreds like you on such an errand, sir. But shouldn't I first take you to a milk shop where they will sell hot milk with crushed almonds to give you stamina?
No.
Just as a routine, my boy. I will take you wherever you want to go. Not my business anyway. Has someone given you more money than you need? Or is your wife pregnant? Well, I know all the tricks husbands often play on their wives. I have seen the world, my master. Please get it. What difference does it make what you look like when you come out of Rangi's house? I will take you wherever you want to go. So where shall we go now, my master? Tell me, sir.
Take me home. 21 Kabir Street.
Don't be depressed, my young master. You're not losing anything.
Hey! Hey!
Just a piece of advice. Never be unfaithful to your wife, sir.
I have my reasons.
Oh, I've heard it all before. Don't tell me. Sir, someday you'll think of this old fellow again.